Space is harsh, and the moon is certainly very harsh. Mars is harsh. There's no other signs of significant life, certainly in our solar system. And so Earth is very, very special. It's a special piece of creation. My favorite pastime on the space station was really looking back at the Earth. To have the liquid water we have, to have the atmosphere we have. You know, and then as life evolved and brought forth photosynthesis and changed the carbon dioxide to oxygen and, you know, and everything else we have here. But it's really cool, because today, as we dedicate the moon tree, as we plant that and dedicate it here on the Texas A&M campus, exactly 50 years ago, the Apollo 14 crew had completed their mission on the moon, and they were on their way back to Earth, and so the timing is perfect for this.
...25 seconds and counting, we are still go. Drew Russo just said, thanks, it's been a good count. Ignition sequence start. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Launch commit, liftoff. We have liftoff with Apollo 14, 3 minutes past the hour.
I vividly remember 14 because I followed all of them, and after the near tragedy, an incredible success and recovery of Apollo 13. I mean, I was riveted. I grew up in McAllen down in the Rio Grande Valley, and I remember very clearly that night after the moonwalk was over and they're back safe inside, I walked into the backyard and I'm just looking up at that moon that's hanging in the sky, and I was pretty sure it was right over my backyard. And just, I remember just shaking with excitement that we did it. And right now, there are three Americans up there right now, and I just watched two of them walking on the moon.
We're on the surface. Okay, we made it. That was a beautiful one. Looks like you're about on the bottom step and on the surface. Bad for an old man. Tower's on the surface, and it's been a long way, but we're here.
Later on, I heard about the moon trees, and it was actually a scientific experiment. And so they took about 500 of these seeds, five different kinds of trees represented, and they brought them back. At the same time, they had an equal number of seeds going through the exact same conditions that stayed on the ground the whole time. And they compared them when they got back to compare the genetics, compare the growth, the germination rates, and all that kind of stuff. And the scientific investigation concluded that the trees that had been to the moon were unchanged. And scientifically, that may be true, but it's also profoundly false, because they've been permanently changed. They've done something, you know, just making that trip into space. It's a very, very unique thing. There are moon trees planted across the country and many of them across the world. I think it's about time Texas A&M got one on our campus here.
Here, we're gonna do it on three. Y'all ready? 1, 2, 3.
Give me one of these.
Perfect, thank you.
Yes, the genetics are essentially unchanged, but it's still, there's a sense of wonder to look at that and to touch the tree that's right here. And when I walked up to it a short time ago before the ceremony, the first thing I had to do was just kneel down and touch it. That's my instinctive reaction to something like that. Now I've made contact with something that's been to the moon. And as this tree grows, I hope it serves as a source of a little bit of inspiration and wonder for the people, the students here at Texas A&M, as well as others that will go and look at that tree as it's stretching its arms toward the heavens and have a little bit of that sense of wonder